Still clicking around Okta to manage users one by one? Let's automate that. In this video, I'm going to show you how to manage Okta in the right way with Terraform. Hi, welcome to Dr. Cloud. I'm Deepak, an automation expert and a DevOps engineer. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can do an automation the right way.
In this video, here's what we are going to do, step by step. First, we'll set up free Okta developer tenant. That's your sandbox to test identity automation. Second, we'll clone a pre-built Terraform lab from GitHub, the same lab I'll be using in every episode of this series. Third, we'll write and apply Terraform code to create user in Okta. No UI clicks, just pure automation. And finally, if this helps you, be sure to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any upcoming automation videos. Let's get our hands on now. We'll set up a free Okta tenant, clone a pre-built Terraform lab environment, and create a user automatically using Terraform. No clicking in the Okta UI. Let's head over to developer.okta.com/signup and create a free developer account. So once you're on Okta Workforce Identity account, you just have to click on the Workforce Identity free trial to get an access for 30 days. You just have to fill in your details. Make sure to use an organization account or the work email which you have for this demo purpose. I'm gonna be using my company account for this purpose. Hit I'm not a bot. Click on verify and hit start a free trial. After verifying your email, you need to sign in on Okta admin console using the email address you have used in order to register for a free trial. Need to set up the password. I've already set up the password for my account, which I'm going to be using in order to sign in. This will gonna ask you to hit to do the Okta verify. You need to set up an Okta verify. In order to get that done, you have to install an Okta verify app on your computer. Once that is done, you need to hit on add account. This will gonna be opening a new browser just to verify. And you have to type in your password again. And once that is verified, you need to enable Touch ID, and that's pretty much it. Now we'll be able to log in our Okta admin console. And there you go. It will gonna ask you to choose the apps that are most important to integrate. For the start, I'm gonna be using only other, and then submit and hit next. Where are we trying to import the users from? I'm gonna choose other, submit. And then what features are you most interested in? I'm gonna be using single sign-on and hit next. And what do you want to solve with Okta? Let's hit on done. Finally, we are inside our trial tenant for Okta, which we're going to be using throughout this course for the Okta demo purposes. Now let's clone the demo lab environment, which I've created for this series. You can go onto the page, evendapp/Okta demo, where you're going to find all the work which we're going to be doing throughout this series on this repository. Once you have opened the code repository in your IDE, I'm using VS Code for this lab purpose. We're gonna be just creating the first folder, which will gonna be the modules folder. Inside of the modules folder, we are gonna be creating another folder, which will gonna be our first to user automation, which we are gonna name user. Inside of this folder, we are gonna be creating our first main.tf file. And we are going to be structuring it with variables .tf. Our output .tf once that is done, we'll on the outside, because we are managing all the modules. Once we have our modules structure already available, what we're gonna do, we're gonna be creating a main.tf file in the root, from where we're gonna be calling our modules folder, as well as the module, which is required for the purpose of creating and managing users. We'll have the same structure which we have created earlier inside of the module underneath user management. But over here, we are going to be providing a providers.tf file, which is must required for any of the Terraform providers calling purposes. And also, we are going to be creating a terraform.tfvars file, from where we are going to be publishing all the name, or maybe we are going to be just providing all the names of the users which we want to create as a part of the user management module. All right, let's head to the official Okta Terraform provider documentation and find the resource we need. Go to registry.terraform.io/providers/okta/okta. Here you'll find the Okta user resource. You can see Terraform providers a clean way to define the user attributes like login, email, first name, last name, and password. Not all the fields are required. So in this lab, we're only going to focus on the essential fields that keep the modules minimal and easy to understand. Next, let's build a basic reusable module to create a user in Okta using the only required fields, first name, last name, and email address. I've already set up the Terraform project with the module folder layout. Inside the modules/user management, you'll find the three key files that every module should include: main.tf for resource definitions, variables.tf for input, and outputs.tf for useful outputs like user ID, login, and status. Here is main.tf. We are defining Okta user resource with only the required fields, all passwords as input variable. Now, if I go into the variables.tf, we declare all variables we plan to pass into this module. Let's move on to the outputs.tf. To make this module more usable, I've added outputs and outputs.tf so we can capture key results in the user ID, login, and the status. Let's head on to the root module. Now, in the root main.tf, we call our module and pass in all required values from our terraform.tfvars. If we go onto our outputs.cli, now we're going to be going into outputs.tf. And in root outputs.tf, we expose all those outputs to our CLI. Let's head on to the providers.tf. In providers.tf, we have defined the Okta provider with required credentials, which are securely loaded from variables. Let's move on to the variables.tf. And finally, in the root variables.tf, we define all variables, including the ones for the Okta provider and the module. Important note, when using modules in Terraform, you must pass the provider configuration explicitly. If you can see inside of my user management module, I have provided this provider definition explicitly over here. Without this, the Terraform module won't work properly when invoked from the root. Now let's go back to our Okta admin dashboard and generate a new API token. Navigate to Security, API, and hit on Tokens. Here you'll have to create a new token for this demo purpose. I've already created one API token already. The token will only going to be shared once. So make sure you are saving that token at a very secure location and do not share it. We are using a standard modular folder structure as shown here on the screen. Now the API key which we have just generated, we're going to be saving it here. Hit on Save. This setup will allow us to scale our automation to manage users, group, policies, MFA, and more, all through the code. As a part of this demo, we will going to save API token in the plain text. But in production environments, we use secrets to keep our API token secure. If you're planning to use this code in production environment, I would highly encourage to make sure you do not save the API token in the Terraform directory in plain text. Now let's run the magic in your terminal. Let's open a terminal in our Visual Studio Code. I'm gonna hit Terraform init to initialize the Terraform. This will going to be downloading all the required provider plugins, etc., in order for us, for Okta to run. After running Terraform init, we are going to be running Terraform plan. What do we have for the Terraform plan to create? And we can see and verify that there is an Okta user which will going to be provisioned for this IP and this login. As we are using very basic information from the Terraform resource in order to create it, we're going to be just focusing in order to create one demo user account in our Okta using Terraform. Now let's hit Terraform apply. This will going to prompt you that, are you sure? Do you accept? I said, yes. And the provisioning of user has been completed. And you can see all the outputs which we have defined are now coming over here. The user status is active. User login is the email address which we have already defined. And the user ID is the specific ID for each and every user which has been given by Okta whenever a new user has been provisioned. Now we can go back to our Okta admin console and we can check the new user is in pending user action. Now the email must have been sent out already, and that's why you can see there is a recent activation email. Now if a user, because this is a demo account, I'm not going to be activating this user, but if a user is there with a right email address in the Terraform file, the user must have received an email and they just have to activate the account. Now, as a part of this demo, what we're going to do, we're also going to try to remove this by using Terraform destroy command. And this will going to ask for confirmation. I'm going to say yes after checking. Yes, this will going to try to destroy the same user which we have just provisioned. Now we're going to say yes, and the user has been destroyed. And we can go back and check in our Okta admin console. Whether you are scaling a startup or running a global team, if you are ready to automate Okta, cloud infrastructure, or CI/CD the right way, I'm here to help. My contact details are in the description and pinned comment. Let's build automation that's secure, scalable, and future ready. And if this video helped you, give it a like, share it with your team, subscribe, and hit the bell. There's plenty more coming your way.